welcome everyone to the finals of the second annual Public Service Data Challenge. We would like to begin this event by acknowledging that we are all meeting on land that has been inherited by Indigenous people from the beginning, currently gathered here in Ottawa, the National Capital Region, which is the traditional unceded, unsurrendered territory of the Algonquin and Anishinaabeg people. We recognize that through that, we all work and live in different places. If you're chiming in virtually, you may be working from different traditional Indigenous territories across the country. So I encourage you to take a moment to reflect on that now and to acknowledge the land on which you stand or are sitting in front of your monitor, as it were. I'm Catherine Stevenson. I'm the Director of Data Integration Infrastructure Division at Statistics Canada. I'll do my side plug that what is that? That is looking after the register of all businesses in Canada, as well as all buildings. So these are statistical registers that form the backbone of infrastructure for StatCan and for many of the government departments out here. And I'm happy to share more about that in the break for anyone who's interested, or ping me on Teams if you're virtual. Always love to talk about the important work that that my team does. I'll be facilitating this afternoon's event, and I have sworn to stay on script. So we are on time and really focused on hearing what the teams have to pitch. So thank you all for coming. Statistics Canada, along with Natural Resources Canada and Global Government Forum, organizes and runs the Data Challenge. And the program is delivered as a collaborative partnership. À l'automne 2023, nous avons demandé aux membres de la fonction publique de nous faire part de leurs idées.
Autumn 2023, we asked to gather idea to employees, government employees, to streamline, to better, to improve the organization of our services, to provide more effective services, and also to give more services to our
ideas around which we formed teams of public servants from many different departments, roles, and levels of seniority, working with colleagues from across government, including NRCan's Digital Accelerator team and innovation experts at StatCan, and with the support of senior leaders, the nine teams researched and developed these ideas. They were presented to our judges at a semifinal event in May, and the final four teams were selected. And I have heard from several people that that was a really tough process. Those of you in the room cannot see the faces of the judges, but they look pained. They look like this legitimately was putting them to the task.
Cet après-midi, nous attendrons la fin du défi et nous saurons laquelle de ces idées gagnera.
So we are here at the end of the challenge and we will know the result.
Each of our finalist teams will make a 10-minute presentation. I'm sure the judges pay attention to whether you stay in the 10 minutes, so I know you've all practiced for that. And then you will face up to 15 minutes of hard-hitting questions from our judges. And after all four teams have pitched, the champions, supported by our judges, will decide the winner, all happening this afternoon. Here are the judges. Gabrielle Fitzgerald, executive, I'm going... Thank you for raising your hand. Executive Director, Chief Data and Risk Officer, Canada Food Inspection Agency. Elise Legendre, Director General, Data Policy and Transformation, Chief Data Officer, Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada. We are therefore indebted to Stephen Burt, Chief Data Officer of Canada, who will be joining us a little bit later. Franck Desrosiers, Assistant Deputy Minister, Strategic Policy and Innovation, Natural Resources Canada, and André Laranger, Chief Statistician of Canada, who's with us in the front row. We want to say thank you to all our champions, advocates, and judges, as well as all the other public service leaders who've helped us run this program. Let's have a round of applause for all those who've been instrumental in the challenge. For a minute, I thought my mic cut out. So this is great validation that actually worked. And that those were very nice applause. Love the energy. Also wanted to say thank you to our partners who brought this program to life, Statistics Canada, Natural Resources Canada, and Global Government Forum. Later, we'll be joined, as I mentioned, by Stephen Burt. André Laranger is here already. They will announce the winner. But first, let me introduce Daniel Dufour, who is representing Franck here today. And he will make some opening remarks.
Good afternoon, everyone. Pleasure to be here on behalf of Franck Desrosiers, who's Assistant Deputy Minister, Natural Resources Canada. So super thrilled to be here, you know, with such a great audience, you know, for the grand finale of the second Public Service Data Challenge. So as Catherine mentioned, my name is Daniel Dussault, and I'm Director General of Innovation at the Department of Natural Resources Canada. And I've been acting as an advocate for the department, and NRCan has been happy to partner. You know, it's been a great partnership, I have to say, with our colleagues from Statistics Canada, from Treasury Board Secretariat, as well as our colleagues from Global Government Forum on the delivery of the second iteration of the Public Service Data Challenge. And super thrilled to be, you know, to be here today to go through the grand finale. So, you know, I'll just say that the challenge has really served as a powerful engine of innovation for Canada's public sector. And this year is obviously, or that second iteration is certainly no exception. As we know well, you know, all of us here today, the world, you know, today's world is really driven by data. And across the government of Canada, we generate, we collect, we analyze hundreds and, you know, thousands of data points in the work that we do every day. And when we collaborate, you know, to collect, to process, to analyze this rich data, we can work at, you know, improving services, at building efficiencies, and ultimately just delivering better outcomes for public servants and Canadians. Un autre point fondamental que je voudrais faire, c'est que pour pleinement utiliser...
So what we want to do is to use this data that the government has, and in order to do that, we need to have the talent. So not only access to data and technologies enabling to have access to such data, we also need the expertise. We need to have a high technology, but in order to make a big change, we need our employees to understand the wide range of technologies that we have in order to translate them that into reality.
You know, it's about breaking down the barriers, you know, to innovation and experimentation. It's really tapping into, you know, expertise and grassroots ideas from, you know, frontline staff across the public service. It's working with public servants across all disciplines, you know, across all organizations, regardless of the levels of seniority. Everybody's invited to submit their ideas and then to join interdisciplinary team. Again, working across departments towards, you know, the most promising proposals. And the collaborative and crowdsourcing approach gives the teams both the skills, the connections, but also the connections basically that they need to really achieve that type of success and achieve greater diversity in terms of talent and culture, creativity, and all of it. So this kind of cross-pollination across different areas of expertise is extremely rare, challenging to achieve, honestly, because we're all, you know, very busy in our own departments, in our own line of works, but it is really groundbreaking and the type of stuff that we need every day to, you know, to push forward in terms of, again, seeing, you know, seeing experimentation and innovation being put at the forefront of what it is we do. So by putting together, working together, you know, on these ideas, the competitors basically have continued to prove the importance of building bridges across departments. That's a really key value of this initiative, is really, again, enabling departments to work together in a very collaborative fashion. And today, you know, basically we see the results of that collaborative work. And we get to, you know, let the judge and the judges enjoy these presentations, these pitches, and make their assessment today. So incredibly excited. Look really much forward to, you know, the pitches this afternoon. Je veux certainement féliciter nos quatre équipes finalistes.
I would like to congratulate our four final teams for their work, hard work, for their ideas.
The format is team one and two, you will make your pitches. We will have a short break, and then the second team three and four will pitch. If you haven't seen this before, picture Dragon's Den, and you've got the format figured out.